There's no mister. It's Higgins, sir.
The National Broadcasting Company presents a new comedy series, It's Higgins, Sir, created and transcribed by Paul Harrison and starring Harry McNaughton as Higgins. Every summer, the entire Roberts family goes down to Uncle Percy's farm for the weekend of the county fair. This year, there's a new member of the family who's never been there, Higgins, the butler. But Higgins has learned to face the newness of life in America as compared to life in England with complete calm and absolute composure.
Me? Go to a farm? Oh, no.
Well, sometimes Higgins isn't as composed and calm as others. But with the children already down on the farm and Mr. Roberts off on a business trip, someone has to go with Mrs. Roberts in the car.
But Mrs. Roberts, the farm and I have absolutely nothing in common.
Oh, come, come, Higgins. I'm sure you'll enjoy yourself there. Uncle Percy has simply all sorts of animals.
Animals, madam? I'm a butler, not a zookeeper.
I just know you'll enjoy it.
Yes.
Let me read the rest of the children's letter to
Please
you.
Please do.
This part is from Debbie. Boy, Mom, are there ever a lot of swell bugs here this summer?
I've got 18 new ones in my bug collection, not counting a great big beautiful one that bit Tommy when he sat on the big rock by the swimming hole. I sat on the rock all day, trying to get the bug to bite me so as I could catch it. But I guess it doesn't like little girls.
New kinds of bugs that bite? Oh, dear, they always find me so delectable.
I wouldn't worry, Higgins. Apparently this bug bites only young boys.
Young boys? Oh, grand. I'll show them my birth certificate.
Well, we'd better get the bags in the car. They'll be expecting us for dinner.
Oh, very well, madam. I'll see to the luggage. My word, I say all these bags for a weekend visit.
Oh, that's not so many.
I say that's a lot of bags, you know. Too many bags.
I'll answer it, Higgins. That must be Aunt Millie.
Aunt Millie, oh, my word, there are too many bags.
Hello there, Elizabeth. Well, are you ready to go?
Hello, Aunt Millie. Yes, we're all ready to leave now.
Oh, I see you're still here.
Madam, there'll always be an England.
You'd better take the bags out to the car, Higgins.
Give me the car keys. I'll drive.
I thought we'd have Higgins drive.
Higgins? Him drive? Elizabeth, I wouldn't trust him.
I am a competent driver, madam, and this sort of thing is a man's job.
Well, I'm a better man than you are.
There must be some way I could disprove that. But it escapes me.
Well, nobody can ever say I'm not a good sport. I'll toss you for it.
Toss me? Toss me? Madam, I have no intention of getting thrown about by you.
No. We'll throw a coin up in the air. If it comes up heads, you drive. If it comes up tails, I drive.
Oh, very well, then. Toss away.
Well, here goes. All right, call it.
Call it? Call it, madam? Oh, yes. Come, Nickel. Come, Nickel. Come, Nickel.
What are you doing?
You said to call it, madam.
Do you want head or tail?
I'll take head. Somehow, the other side's more appropriate for you.
Okay, there it goes. And it came up tails. I drive.
Well, I'm glad that's settled.
Here, Higgins, hold my pickles.
Hold your what, madam?
Those are Aunt Millie's pickles. She makes them every year for the county fair.
And I win first prize every year, too. Now, handle them very careful. I had a jar last year that exploded.
Exploded? My word, if they explode in the jar, what happens when you eat them?
Say, Uncle Percy, Thomas says you don't have ducks this year because they're noisy.
Yep.
You know how they are, Debbie. Quack, 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 all the time.
Yep.
But ducks are so much fun.
Couldn't stand ducks. They reminded me of my sister Millie.
You mean the way they go quack, quack all the time?
Nope, the way they walk.
Oh, wait, Tommy, look. There's our car.
Yep.
Oh, gosh, look, they're driving right down the middle of the road.
Look, they're wobbling from one side of the road to the other.
Millie's driving. Drives like a duck, too.
Hiya, Mom.
Hiya, Tommy.
Uncle Percy, it's so good to see you again.
Hello, Percy. Things going all right on the farm?
Yep.
Uncle Percy, this is Higgins, our new butler.
Oh, yes, I'm Millie's brother. You have my condolences, sir.
Butler, you said?
Yes, Higgins is a butler from England.
You come a long way looking for work.
No, no, sir. No, I wasn't looking for work. I brought Mr. and Mrs. Roberts a legacy.
A leg of what?
I said a legacy. They inherited a very old set of Queen Anne silverware, and I came with it.
Oh, yep, all the way from England. Well, I ain't never met no butler before.
And I've never met a farmer before, face to face.
Kind of scary for both of us, ain't it?
You be careful with my prized pickles, Higgins. You better not let anything happen to them.
Madam, they are as safe in my hands as they would be in the underground vaults of the Bank of England.
She had a jar explode last year.
Really?
I was picking pickles off the walls for weeks.
Very funny, sir. Oh, very funny. Uproariously funny.
Well, how come you're not laughing?
But I am. I'm literally shaking with merriment.
Higgins, my pickles, stop shaking.
My word, I can't stop. Oh, that was so funny.
Higgins, the pickles, hand them to me.
Yes, madam, here you are.
Oh. Head for cover. The pickles will be dropping for days. Oh. Look out, here comes a hunk of water. Oh.
My word, hit me right in the face. Oh, my word, they are sour.
Oh, that was your fault, you low down.
Now, Aunt
you
Millie,
good for nothing nincompoop.
Come on, you.
Please.
We want to show you the farm.
What are we waiting for?
Higgins, I could kill you for exploding my pickles.
Quick, let's go.
Now, look, Aunt Millie, there must be another jar down in the cellar.
If I lose that prize, you're going to lose that butler.
Come on, Master Thomas and Debbie, come along.
Right behind you, Higgins.
You know, when Millie turns bright red like that, it don't pay to hang around and try to be sociable.
Gee, Higgins couldn't help it. It was an accident.
Yeah. Hey, me and Debbie will show Higgins around, Uncle Percy.
And we'll gather the eggs.
Yeah, well, now, I wouldn't go around cows dressed like that.
You mean my clothes might disturb them?
With that derby and those striped pants and that wing collar, you'd curdle her milk.
Gee, maybe you should put on some overalls like Uncle Percy's wearing, Higgins.
Oh, no, indeed not, Pastor Thomas. Thank you very much. My grandfather wore these clothes all his life. My father wore these clothes all his life. And I intend to wear these clothes all my life.
That's a mighty good wearing suit. Now, if they was to come with two pair of pants, I'd get me one like it.
Yes.
Come on, Higgins, let's go. And we'll be careful not to scare anything, Uncle Percy.
Yep.
Here's the egg basket. We'll get the eggs first.
Eggs?
Well, sure. Uncle Percy's got 1,000 hens right in here.
My word. My word, thousands of chickens. Oh, I say, look at them milling about and jabbering to each other.
You help us, Higgins. Just reach under the hens in the nest and take the eggs out.
Reach under the hens with my bare hands? I say, after all, you know.
Oh, go ahead, Higgins. We gotta hurry.
All right. There. I'm under. I say, there's nothing here. Oh, I say, how terribly embarrassing. She laid the egg right in my head. And look at her. Look at her. She's blushing.
Okay. Now get the next nest.
Yes, Master Thomas. You know I've got the knack now. Gracious. No eggs here. Come, chicken. You're a slacker. Oh, yes, you're a slacker, all right. Lay that egg instantly.
That one's a rooster, Higgins.
Well, that's a mighty poor excuse.
He's a boy chicken.
Uncle Percy keeps the rooster to wake him up in the morning.
Wake him up? Fancy that. Imagine that little bird walking all the way over to the house every morning and knowing exactly which room Uncle Percy sleeps in.
He stands right here and crows. That's what wakes Uncle Percy.
Well, I guess that's all the eggs.
No, it isn't. You forgot the egg from that hen in the barn. The broody one. She hides her eggs to keep us from getting them.
She hides her eggs in the barn?
She wants to sit on them.
Sit on them? What sort of a hobby is that?
She wants to hatch them and have a family.
And imagine knowing you're a chicken and wanting to bring more chickens into the world.
She's up in the hayloft. Hear her?
Right up that way, Higgins.
This ladder here. This way up.
Yeah.
There she is, over there in the corner.
Nothing but hay up here.
Oh, be careful where you walk, Higgins. The hay shooter's around somewhere.
Is that another egg? Right. Oh, over here. Oh.
Where did Higgins go?
Oh, he was standing right over there. Oh, Debbie, the hay chute.
Harry, maybe Higgins hurt himself.
Help! Get me out of here.
We're coming, Higgins. There he is.
Help me out of here. This cow is trying to eat me.
She's only eating the hay.
I refuse to depend on her judgment.
Come on, Higgins. Now, crawl out.
My word. Now, where is my derby?
Gee, you must have lost it in the hay.
It'll be pretty hard to find.
But it's my favorite hat. It's custom made by the London Boulder Company.
Not here.
I don't see it either.
Oh, I say, this is simply dreadful. No derby. Why, I've worn a derby constantly for the past 27 years. How embarrassing. I'd rather go without my trousers than without my derby.
Hi, Percy.
Hi, Danny.
Millie still making a fresh batch of pickles in the kitchen?
Yep.
Still smells bad as they ever did?
Yep.
I went in the kitchen to windard. Came right out here.
Say, how is Ermitrude?
Well, she's nervous about contesting in the fair tomorrow.
Sounds nervous.
I can always tell when she's upset.
You know, I reckon you better sleep out here tonight and soothe her a mite.
Reckon better.
Ermitrude's got a heart set on that blue ribbon at the fair. She'd feel mighty bad if she didn't get to go.
Look there. Looks like she understood you. Appears like a tear rolling down her face.
Never could stand seeing a woman cry. I'm going out for a breath of air.
I better get me a blanket if I'm going to stay out here all night.
Oh, Mr. Young. Mr. Young, is that you?
Yep.
Oh, I say, that pickle-making business in the house makes the out-of-doors so desirable.
Yep. Smells pretty bad, don't it, Mr. Higgins?
It's not Mr., sir. It's just Higgins.
All right, if you're Higgins, I'm Percy.
But I'm a butler, sir.
Yep.
And it isn't proper for me to call you by your Christian name.
Okay, Mr. Higgins.
My word, you are stubborn, sir.
Yep.
Aunt Millie is your sister.
Yep.
Strong-minded woman.
Yep.
I say, you have a very large farm here.
Yep.
Rather a lot of work for you and your hired hand, Danny.
Yep.
Tell me, do the two of you cook for yourselves?
Yep.
Wouldn't it be easy to have a woman about?
No.
Have you ever thought about getting married?
Yep.
Why don't you?
You seen my sister, Millie?
Yep.
That's why I'm single.
Has she ever been interested in a man?
Yep.
Amazing.
Yep. The boy was six and Millie was five. The boy dared Millie to eat a worm, she ate it. Ever since then, she's hated men.
Ah, I see, a psychological quirk.
Yep. Good night, Mr. Higgins.
I'm just Higgins, sir. Good night, Mr. Young. Well, I'm going to stay out here until that pickle-making party in the kitchen is all through.
Who's that standing there outside the bar?
It is I, Madam Higgins.
Yeah, well, don't you go pussyfooting around here the way you do at the Roberts. Someone's liable to take a shotgun after you.
Really, madam? Is it open season on butlers here?
It's always open season on butlers who wreck my pickles. No thanks to you, I've got another jar to enter in the contest at the county fair tomorrow.
I see. And where are you taking it?
To the stone cooler out in the barn. I've won the blue ribbon with them every year.
I admire your confidence, madam, but isn't it possible for you to lose?
Me? Lose? Why, they wouldn't dare.
You have a point there.
Now, out of my way, Butterfingers. I'm going to put my pickles away.
Good night, madam.
Oh, hello there, Higgins.
Oh, yes, Mr. Denny. Gracious, I say you're carrying a blanket.
Yeah, going in the barn, spend a little time with the old girl.
Old girl? Old girl. Oh, indeed, yes.
Yeah, she's always the same way before the county fair. Yeah. She's so anxious to win, she gets all nervous and upset.
Yes. She did seem rather anxious to win.
So I'll just spend the night with her out here in the barn.
Spend the night in the barn? Really?
Well, sure, I don't mind. It ain't exactly my idea of an exciting evening, but makes her feel better.
Yeah. She doesn't exactly seem your type, does she?
Yeah, you got a good sense of humor.
Oh, yeah. Delightful when I'm properly tickled. Does Mr. Young know you're spending the night out here with the old girl?
Why, sure, it was his idea.
Oh, I see. His idea, eh? My word, some sort of psychological treatment for the worm-eating episode.
What?
Nothing. Oh, nothing at all. Nothing at all, Ober. I'm sure Mr. Young knows what he's doing.
After all, she's pretty fond of me. I got little ways to make her happy, like scratching her behind the ears.
Say, please, I mean, I feel I'm too involved already.
Well, I better get in there. She'll be pretty anxious.
Well, she's in there, all right. I just saw her.
You know, she's in pretty good shape this year.
I suppose so, if you like a shape like that.
Of course, I'm a little worried. She looked a little upset. Kind of a queer look in her eyes.
Oh, yes, queer look. She always looks like that, doesn't she?
She'll win tomorrow. The judges always go for the way she's built.
My word. My word. I say, Danny, you talk about her as though she were a cow.
Well, that's what she is, ain't she?
Yes, but I wouldn't say it where everyone could hear me.
And that's from out in the barn.
Good heavens, what was that?
Oh, it's Ermatrude.
Oh, no, sir, that's Aunt Millie.
Millie? What's Millie doing down in the barn?
Well, you see, sir, she's...
What's all the racket about? What's wrong in the barn?
Now, just what was you saying, Mr. Higgins?
Nothing. I'm still asleep.
All right, quiet, 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 everybody. It's just Ermatrude. We was worried she'd get sick. Mr. Higgins, you come along and help me and Danny. And you kids, get on back to bed. This is no job for kids.
All right, now come on, children. Let's go to bed. Uncle Percy and Higgins will take care of Ermatrude.
You need me, Percy?
Why, no. I can't say I do, Millie. You save your strength. You got to show your pickles tomorrow. Come on, Mr. Higgins.
What do you think is wrong, sir?
Oh, Ermatrude is good and sick. I was afraid she was going to get sick. That's... That's why I had Danny set up with her tonight.
Danny was sitting up with her tonight?
For sure. You didn't think he was setting up with Millie, did you?
Oh, no, sir. Oh, no, of course not. Why would I think of a thing like that?
You said Millie was in the barn. Yeah. Of course, I gotta admit that bellerin sounded a wee bit like Millie.
Oh, she's bad off, Percy. Hit her real sudden, like.
Get the liniment, Danny.
Yeah, right away, Percy.
You there, Mr. Higgins. Run over to the cooler and bring some milk.
Milk from the cooler, yes.
Here's the liniment, Percy.
Yeah. Ah, poor Ermatrude. We're gonna make you feel better, honey. Now, you just relax.
Oh, see? She knows you, Percy.
Here's the milk, sir.
All right, give her a drink.
Yes, sir. Here you are, cow. A drink of nice, cool milk.
Hey, she can't drink out of no glass like that.
Shall I get her a straw?
Yes, get her a straw. No, stand back.
Oh, yes, of course. How silly of me.
She's opening her eyes.
Yes.
Oh, now, I'm a trude, honey. You just tell Percy what's wrong.
My word, she did.
It's something she ate. She can't get her cut up.
She can't get her cut up? My word, that's terrible. What's a cud?
Well, now you see, a cow's got four stomachs.
Four stomachs? Oh, I see, a cow has four stomachs. Oh, I see, yes, one for each faucet. Naturally.
And you see, when she eats grass, she just puts it in the first stomach.
Oh, of course, I see, and with four stomachs, she's forgotten where she put it.
Drink the milk, Ermatrude.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. What's that on your tongue, Ermatrude?
Yes, what is it?
Looks like the label out or something.
Mm-hmm.
It says...
What does it say?
London Bowler Company. Now, how'd she get that?
My word. My derby.
Now, Higgins, you run up the house and get all the blankets. No, you and me better do it, Danny.
I know, but what about me, sir?
Well, you go to the cooler in there and get that jar of cud bomb. Feed the whole thing to her.
Cud bomb?
Yeah, it's my own invention.
It is?
I always perks up a cow. It's in the cooler next to the butter.
Cud bomb? Yes, sir. Dark here in the cooler. Better light a match. Ah, there's the jar. Oh, my word, what a repulsive-looking mess. That must be the cud bomb. You'll have to eat this mess, Ermatrude, and you have my deepest sympathy. My gracious, she's actually eating it. She's eating that dreadful mess. My word. Oh, it's working. She's getting up. She's feeling better. She's standing straight up. My word, she's rigid. Oh, it's a miracle to think a homemade concoction like... what is it called? Oh, it's right here on the jar. Millie Young, pickled watermelon, rind, and onion. No. Aunt Millie's pie's pickle mess. I fed it to the cow. Oh, Ermatrude's tail is standing straight up. Oh, Aunt Millie will kill me when she finds out what I've done. Oh, my word, I've got to do something quickly. Ah, the cud balm in the cooler. Here's the cud balm. I'll just put it right back in the pickle jar. It looks like the pickles. There. Now to close the pickle jar and put it back on the shelf. That's right. There we go. The cud balm looks better than the pickles did. Oh, my word, if she ever finds out what I've done. At least you're feeling better, Ermatrude. No, stay away from me, Ermatrude. Stay away. Oh, my goodness. Ermatrude, get back, please. No. Get back. Get away from me.
My land of grocery. She's up. The cud balm did it.
Yes, sir. And would you help me, sir? She has me backed away in this corner. Please get her away from me.
Oh, would you look at her tail? Standing straight up.
Please, sir, please get this cow away from me. She's starting to lick.
Yeah, back there, Ermatrude, back. Back, girl, back. Gosh, she sure likes you, Mr. Higgins.
Oh, thank you so much for rescuing
me. Why, you're better with her than Danny is. Say, why don't you stay with her the rest of the night? She really likes you.
Me, sir?
Yep, she's got to win tomorrow, and whatever she wants, she gets. And right now, she wants you.
She does?
Now, you stay out here in the barn with her, Mr. Higgins.
Stay out here in the barn all night? Oh, Mr. Young, I can't do that. I catch cold in the head so easily.
Well, if I get your derby, will you stay?
My derby? Oh, yes, my derby. Say, she gave back the label. Perhaps my derby may turn up.
Quiet now, children. I think the judges are going to announce another winner.
Didn't Ermitrude look wonderful?
And now the final grand prize winner in the AAA class of producing cows, the winner, Ermitrude von Terwilliger, owned by Percy Young.
She won! Oh, boy,
yep,
she won!
You did it. And Mr. Higgins is the one responsible.
Higgins, I think what you did was just wonderful. I had no idea you had such a way with animals.
I didn't either, madam. But to cows, my appeal is apparently limitless.
Well, Percy, now we'll have two blue ribbons in the family. I think they're going to announce the pickle winner now. Here's where I get my blue ribbon. I can do anything a cow can do.
I wouldn't advise overconfidence, madam.
Well, I've won every year for 27 years. Why shouldn't I be confident?
And now for the finals of the pickle contest. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a real surprise for you. Every year for the past 27 years, Miss Millie Young has won this contest.
That's me.
But this year, the winner is Miss Violet Rensselaer.
Violet? Why, that man's out of his mind. Let me get up there and talk to him.
Now, Millie, let's not do anything rash.
Oh, yes, yes, don't get excited.
Why shouldn't I be excited? I've been cheated out of my blue ribbon. Hey, Tolliver, stand right there. I'm coming.
Millie, now, Millie, it ain't my fault. Not complete. There was other judges.
What kind of a crooked deal is this about my pickles?
You lost fair and square, Millie.
But how come? They were the same pickles I make every year. How come I lost?
Oh, they were good pickles, I gotta admit that, but not much like pickles usually are. Something different about them. Fact is, I ate about 4 or 5 spoonfuls. Mighty tasty, too. But I can tell you right now, they made me feel like going out to pasture and eating grass.
I don't understand how I could lose. Someone tampered with my pickles.
No one would dare.
And just think, Aunt Millie, Ermitrude won.
Oh, boy, Ermitrude won the blue ribbon. Gee, the fair was awful good this year.
Can't understand what happened to my pickles.
Now, let's all drink a toast to Ermitrude now.
Yes.
In her own milk. I pour a glass for everybody, Mr. Higgins.
Yes.
Ermitrude's own blue ribbon milk. And I'm mighty proud to be drinking it. A toast to Ermitrude!
Ermitrude!
Holy mackerel, that milk tastes awful.
Oh, why, that milk tastes just like...
Great land of Goshen, I can taste my watermelon and onion pickles.
What are you complaining about, madam? I can taste my derby.
This has been It's Higgins, Sir, a new comedy series starring Harry McNaughton with Vera Ellen, Charles Neville, Norma Jane Marlowe, Ethel Owen, and Bob Hay. It's Higgins, Sir was directed and transcribed by Paul Harrison and written by Paul Harrison and Rick Bullard.
Join Jack Pearl and Mimi Benzel next on NBC.